Good morning, and a very happy Easter to you. Our gospel for today is from Mark 16, 1 through 8. I'm so happy you can join me this Easter morning. Easter for me is a very exciting time of celebration. But for those who were part of Jesus' friends, they were very sad. They did not know what we know now, that Jesus will rise. In today's gospel, the Sabbath is over, and now they can go back and prepare Jesus' body. In the Jewish community, Saturday is the day for their service, so they cannot do any work on that day. So they have to return to the tomb later to be able to prepare Jesus' body. They are getting hints that something very new is happening. He has been laid in the tomb. The tomb was guarded. But get this. This is the new story. Somehow the stone covering the tomb has been rolled away and Jesus is no longer there. Jesus told them that he would rise, and now he has disappeared. He will join them over the next 40 days before he rises to be with our Father. Easter is the end of Lent. In the beginning of new life, Christ has risen. The Lord has risen indeed. Can you say it with me? You ready? Let's say it together. Christ has risen. The Lord has risen indeed. Let's do that again. Repeat it with me. Christ has risen. The Lord has risen indeed. Happy Easter, and thank you for joining me.
It's stand up now. It's time to say together the Nicene Creed, which will come up on your screen, with me. So you ready? Here we go. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Well done, kids.
Thank you.
join me in saying our prayer together. Holy and gracious God, we give you thanks for this time and the chance to worship together. We look forward to the time when we can be all together in the choir room once again. Now be with us as we join our parents once again for the prayers of the people for today. In your name we pray. Amen. Have a great Easter, and thank you for joining me.